Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see a simple approach to enable self-signed certificate on Tomcat server. I am using Tomcat 9.0 server for this configuration. As a first step, let us generate the self-signed certificate. So for that, access this specific URL, 0ssl.com. So this will help you to generate the self-signed certificate. Also, if you required a free let's encrypt domain-specific certificate, that same thing can be generated from here. So if you see here, like a free SSL certificate wizard, so you can generate the free domain specific let's encrypt certificate. So also here you can generate the self-signed certificate generator. We are going to generate the self-signed certificate here. Just to click on start. Okay, now just enter the domain as localhost, click on generate. Yeah, now the private key and the certificate is generated. Download this into your machine. Now copy this both of these files to the Apache server's conf folder. Yeah, now you need to rename these files. Like rename this crt.txt file to crt.crt. So the extension should be CRT. You can rename the file name if required. Also, like key.txt, rename this to key.perm. Okay, now the files are renamed. Now we need to enable the secure connector in Tomcat. We are ready with the self-signed certificate. We need to enable that in Tomcat server. So for that, open this server.xml. Yeah, here you can see some secure connectors already enabled, but it's commented out, but you can see some samples here, this one. But I am going with a little different configuration, but it's a mix of both the connector. So let me paste it here. Yeah, so I am taking this configuration from here. So here the certificate, I am referring through certificate key file, this perm file key.perm, then certificate file, this crt.crt. But there is multiple different way to include the certificate. One way is like you can convert the certificate or this key file and the crt file into a PKCS 12 format file. Then you can include here like this certificate key store file, but that little different configuration is required. Also, you can convert that PKCS 12 formatted file to this JKS file, and you can include, but anyway, we are not going with that because in this approach, like direct approach, we don't want to do any conversions. So if you see here, this I took this connector HTTP neo protocol, but this configuration I just copied from here because I want the direct certificate inclusion. So here if you see a certificate chain file, anyway, I'm not going to configure because this is a self-signed certificate. Okay, other than that, like I enabled the port number as 443, nothing my other important configuration here, max threads and SSL enabled true. Only here is like a certificate key file, then certificate file, then type RSA. Okay, now the configurations are ready. So now go and start the server. So go here. Okay, let me start the server. Okay, now the server started in two port numbers. One is 8080, 8080 and 443 for secure, 8080 for HTTP. Okay, let me go and access the page now. So go and access localhost. Yes. Yeah, it's a 443, so it's a default. You can leave it. Yeah. Now, if you see, the page is opened. The certificate is not secure. Your connection is not private because it's a self-signed. If you go here and see, the certificate is applied, but it is localhost certificate, also self-signed. Because of that, it's saying like there is no valid CA root certificate. That's fine for us. This is mainly for testing purpose. So just to click on advance. So proceed to the page. Yeah, now you can see the page is accessible through HTTPS. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.